Athens, city of the gods. The school of Hellas, in the words of the Athenian historian Thucydides. A modern megalopolis that preserves intact the memories of her past. Crossroad of peoples and cultures, birthplace of intellectual wisdom and artistic expression. The city symbol of the Olympic Games. In Athens, let your mind wander nostalgically to the past. Let your senses delight freely the present. In the Greek capital, the Attica Metro holds many pleasant surprises. It doesn't take long for the visitor to Athens to get to know its loveliest parts, while at the same time enjoying one of the finest metros in the world. At the heart of the city is Syndagma Square with its own special splendor. Hub of the history of modern Greece. Almost every visitor to Athens spends the first few hours exploring Plaka. The quaint old neighborhood is like a superb stage set. Time has passed this way and etched its presence everywhere. This lively corner of Athens, open to the world, keeps its allure all year round. When night falls, Plaka becomes truly beautiful. Everything flows in the rhythm of authenticity. In its traditional tavernas, every day is a feast day. Hospitality here is not just a feeling, it's a way of life, with most ancient roots. As the hours pass, Athenian nights offer images found nowhere else. Magical nights filled with pleasure. Athens is an inexhaustible well of surprises. The more you discover, the closer you bond. Every day in this city is a wonderful and unforgettable experience. The highlight is, without doubt, the visit to the Acropolis. The Parthenon, the temple epitomizing beauty and art.
The Parthenon is the most beautiful of all the monuments, hence the monument.
A work of spiritual perfection, acknowledged worldwide as man's ultimate achievement. Here, every art form reached its zenith. At the edge of the sacred rock, The Acropolis Museum. Unique in the world for its precious collections. On the south slope of the Acropolis, places where the highest form of art developed, leading word and thought to the pinnacle of their expression. The Theatre of Dionysos, cradle of dramatic art. And close by, the Odeum of Herodes Atticus, specially designed in those days for performances of music and plays. The Hill of the Areopagus, from where Paul the Apostle preached to the Athenians of the unknown God. Opposite is the Hill of the Pnyx. Amidst these rocks, the ideas of justice and democracy flowered. The Acropolis and its environs, a marvelous archaeological park. Ancient, Roman and Byzantine buildings await one at every step, reviving memories of an illustrious past. Monuments that unite the ages and perpetuate the Greek capital's glory. Athens is a city of contrasts, which endow her with a personality all her own. Monastiraki is a veritable picture album. People, dreams, vendors and buyers crowding the streets. After sightseeing on the Acropolis and the areas around, the time has come for a delicious meal. In some shaded sidewalk cafe or in a cool lobby of one of the excellent hotels that grace the Greek capital. The choice is yours. Athens hotels are tastefully decorated and well appointed. Modern units to meet all needs. Here the tourist can choose what suits him best. Culture is the eternal soul of Athens. The visitor gets some sense of this when attending one of the many cultural events organized here. Samnites at the foot of the Acropolis, exhilarating for the intellect and the emotions. After an outstanding performance, there is always some beach to win your heart. Nightlife on the Saronic coast knows no bounds. The visitor to Athens can enjoy the sea and sun in many ways. He can always escape to the cool of the Apollo coast. Piraeus, the port of many songs. From here one can sail in only a few hours to the islands of the Argo-Saronic Gulf. Just a breath away from Athens, one can enjoy super moments at sea. The Saronic shores are a taste of rare beauty. Here, everything reveals a bright and happy world. Modern hotel complexes in choice locations promise a friendly and pleasant stay. Touring Attica is a wonderful experience. Everywhere the sun, the sea spray and the colors of Greece. Sunion, the sacred cape of the ancient Greeks. Imposing on the rocks, master of the waves of the Aegean Sea, the Temple of Poseidon. One of the handsomest temples of classical times. In Lavrion, old and new, plain and pretty, poetry and imagination recreate the life that once flourished here. The Attic Peninsula is unique in synthesis. Alongside the modern stand the creations of antiquity. Brauron, Marathon, as far as the Amphiaraion. A judicious balance between natural beauty and historical memory. Boredom is an unknown word in Athens. After a tiring day of roaming, a quiet moment is essential. An opportunity to take a walk in the city center. The National Garden and the Zapion Park are oases in the heart of Athens. Opposite, the all-marble Panathinaik Stadium, where the Olympic Games were revived in the spring of 1896. And here again, At the dawn of the new millennium, the Olympic spirit will embrace the youth of the world. Athens is exceptionally rich in monuments, museums, collections of historical and artistic interest. Her museums are unique and their exhibits priceless. Shopping in Athens is a must. Luxury stores with an endless variety of goods make the Greek capital one of the largest shopping centers in Europe. It's well worth a visit. Your stay in Athens is truly a wonderful opportunity to explore the past and enjoy the present. Usually, the last few hours of a trip roll by calmly. A last visit to the foot of the sacred rock, a kind of farewell, and certainly some souvenir. Foretaste of departure and promise of return to the city of the gods.
On the southernmost tip of Europe, at the crossroads of three continents and five oceans, Crete enlightens visitors with the uniqueness of her 5,000-year-old history. Those who have visited Crete and have become acquainted with her soul say she may be a piece of the lost continent of Atlantis. It is one of the most important links in the chain of great Mediterranean civilizations, an open door on the roads of the West and the East. To know Crete is to sense the feeling of Europe's roots. Here, in the land of Cortina, Zeus, the god of gods, transformed himself into a bull and abducted Europe because he fell madly in love with her. It is here Europe first heard others call her by her name. In museums, monasteries, and in archives, old manuscripts and on indestructible icons move the shadows of the world's greatest poets, writers, and artists, from Domenico Theotokopoulos, the famous painter known throughout the world as El Greco, to Nikos Kazantzakis' immortal heroes Zorba the Greek and Captain Michali. The Cretan and his history, the landscape of Crete and her nature are tied to a harmonic symphony of light, aromas, colors, and sounds. Rekindled by the pains and joys of life, proud people of a land of endless heritage, Cretans abandoned themselves to generous hospitality, sacred traditions, and enthusiastic revelry. Those who would like to acquaint themselves with the Crete of ancient myths and history should begin their journey today. Of the many museums on this large island, the most important one is in Heraklio, and this is our starting point. The Museum of Heraklio holds unparalleled Cretan works of art, chronicling its history from the moment life appeared on the island to the first centuries AD. The relationship between Cretans and nature has been sacred from ancient times. Any observer will bear witness that the most genuine evidence of this relationship is in the rich archaeological discoveries, where the deification of nature and the sacred link between the Minoan gods and the Earth's fertility is readily distinguishable. In the ruins of Knossos, one can secretly listen to the passage of thousands of years of history. The palace accompanies the most significant place in the area and gives lasting impression of the greatness of the Minoans. When one carefully observes the corridors, chambers, decorated fabric of the complex within the 1,300 rooms, one understands why Knossos so greatly impresses the visitor. Festos. At the west end of Mesada, in the old upper city, first mentioned by Homer, the second most significant Minoan palace was found. Here, the famous Disc of Phissos was discovered. The deciphering of the writing, found on both sides of the disc, remains an enigma to this day. Crete is an open museum of Byzantine architecture and painting. Even today, some 850 temples remain, with well-preserved frescoes depicting many timeless masterpieces of Byzantine art. The many monasteries also give us the chance to acquaint ourselves with the astonishing cultural treasures. Arkadi is one of the most beautiful monasteries in Crete. Externally resembles an inaccessible castle, while the entire construction, which was built during the Venetian rule in 1587, contains souvenirs of its history. Hagia Triada is a unique architectural masterpiece of the Cretan Renaissance. The Governato and the Vrondisio Monastery were home to renowned clergymen and artists, such as Mikhail Damaskinos and the young Domenico Theotokoplos. The Toplu Monastery is a temple and a fortress, a retreat and museum of the most historic significance on the island of Crete. And amongst the dozens of historical monasteries is that of Agio Giacinthu, the patron saint of lovers. The Priveli Monastery lies south of Rethymno and overlooks the Libico Sea. A visit to this site offers not only touristic, but also historical interest. The visitor will have a chance to admire examples of ecclesiastic art and then relax on one of the most beautiful beaches of the Libico Sea. Here, there is a sense of the beginning of the creation of the world. Lying in the Aegean Sea, Crete extends 260 kilometers from east to west. Its beaches strain over 1,050 kilometers. Crete, with her mild Mediterranean climate, offers an ideal vacation spot all year round. The magnificent rays of the sun play unabatedly with the waters, rocks, and ocean bed, and the open horizons create splendid, dreamlike colors. Isolated or popular, deserted or noisy, Crete's beaches offer an abundance of all vacation joys. Hotels of all categories, from the most luxurious to the most simple, small and large, welcome their guests, offering an endless variety of holidays on a paradise island. The hotel industry on Crete is one of the most modern in Greece and one of the best in Europe. The capability to offer services of high standard in the large hotels on the island with advanced technology has distinguished Crete in the area of tourist development over the past few years. Conference tourism. Research and technical institutes, as well as international corporations of all sorts, use locations in Crete for their scientific and business conferences. Following a path from west to east, that is, the axis from Chania to Setia, a visitor will notice that Crete embraces a modern lifestyle without negating her authenticity and greatness. Cities and most significant tourist areas on Crete look out onto the Aegean Sea. Heraklion, the largest city on Crete. The archaeological interest of the region, its natural environment, and modern rhythm of life make it one of the greatest tourist centers of Europe. The Venice of the East. For many, this is the most picturesque city in Crete. It was built on the ruins of ancient Kydonia, which is now gradually appearing from the excavations underway in the center of the city. Chania's centuries-old buildings, Venetian houses, and fortresses are the vestiges of a past splendor. The area of the old city, with its scenic port at its center, is a living historical monument. Today, in the Venetian Temple of San Francisco, is a rich archaeological museum in Chania, which houses remarkable findings and ancient treasures. The safe and modern airports of Heraklion and Chania accommodate thousands of visitors who come from all over the world. The ship companies of Crete are the most up-to-date and active in Greece, whose old sailing tradition dates back to the ancients. In Rethymno, the Venetian Fortezza Citadel reigns. Together with the Lodzia, they are considered the best preserved Venetian structures in Greece. A walk through the narrow, quaint and flowered streets in Rethymno awakens within you the feeling that you are experiencing daily scenes of eras from the past. Fountains and minarets, stone carved doors and green squares, colored facades and decorated interior rooms all create a unique ambiance. Mm-hmm. Agios Nikolaos. A modern city and picturesque at the same time. Here, its point is joined to the Voulizmeni, a small, beautiful lake in the heart of the city. The lake is surrounded by little bars and restaurants which vibrate with the gusto of life. There are daily boat rides departing from Agios Nikolaos, which offer unforgettable sea excursions to the sunken province of ancient Elunda and the island fortress Aspinalonga. Hierapetra is a scenic example of the medieval and modern city. It's an ideal place for holidays with excellent swimming, seaports, excursions, gastronomic delights, and nightlife. The Venetian castle, which protected the port, is today one of the most beautiful city attractions. Sitia remains, even today, a city tied to tradition, letters, and arts. Its residents have maintained their local customs and habits to a large extent, and the area remains a paradise of picturesque towns, historical monasteries, and world-acclaimed beaches. A palm forest in Europe means no more than Vai, and Vai is one of the most beautiful attractions of Crete. A creation of the unexpected eccentricity of nature, Vai surprises the unsuspecting visitor with its self-sown palm trees, which grow all the way down to the blue ocean, creating a protected ecosystem of exotic beauty. Crete is an island of caves and gorges. Over 2,000 caves are known today. The most famous of these are linked to ancient Greek tradition. Even more impressive than the innumerable caves of Crete are the gorges. It is worth exploring these natural chasms, which have no equal in magnificence throughout all of Europe. The world-famous Sumerian Gorge, wild and imposing, is 18 kilometers in length, 500 meters in depth, and 40 meters wide. In certain areas, the width is limited to 3 meters. From here, the local boat circumnavigates the Sfakiani shore and passes by the quaint town of Lutro and finally docks in the town of Sfakion. Sfakia means the land of gorges. Sfakia is the area wildest in nature formation on the island of Crete. The people of this area led the struggle for Crete's independence. The most significant monument to this struggle is the Frango Castello. Inside and around this square castle, built by the Venetians in 1371, countless people lost their lives. Located in the fertile plains of Messara, very close to Festo, is another of Crete's famous beaches, Matala. The small old fishing town with healing waters has become a modern tourist center, where once, not too many years ago, was a hippie paradise. Graves carved on rocks, the peaceful landscape, and the emerald waters create a dreamy scene. On Crete, a visitor can enjoy many types of tourism. The incomparable natural and cultural environment, in combination with unique foundations and careful planning, affords the possibility for alternative forms of tourism, which include amazing tours, sports, sailing, horseback riding, hillside parachuting, and whatever else your heart may desire. But let us not forget the world-famous Cretan wine. This nectar of the gods is praised by poets, writers, and travelers to the island of Minos from Homer's time through today. The wines and the virgin Cretan olive oil accompany all the tastes of authentic Cretan cuisine, which is now considered to be one of the healthiest and tastiest diets in the entire world. Hospitality was, is, and will remain a sacred concept for Cretans. A traveler wandering throughout the cities, towns, and roads of contemporary contemporary Crete will taste the offerings of the locals as a sincere liberation in honor of hospitable Zeus, exactly as their predecessors did thousands of years ago.
Εγώ μου που σε γλέντζα και τώρα μ' απαρνέσαι.
The traditional wedding is the most sacred of Crete's many beautiful customs. Ancient traditions are still observed, and the festivities are truly splendid. The rapid rhythm of the music, the improvised rhyme of the songs, the gallant dance, and abundant wine lead to Dionysian revelries, unique for their intensity and magnificence. The traditional black clothing spins ceremoniously and virile with the rhythm of the lira players at festivals, parties, and holidays. Nights on Crete are unique. Within the multiple characteristics of musical sounds, which cover all demands, you have the possibility to choose your own form of enjoyment and entertainment. A trip to Crete is a special experience in a special land, where ancient gods and myths participate, as do people with enthusiasm for life and a generosity of spirit, places of inconceivable beauty and a nature generous in seawater, wind, sun, and life.
The Ionian Islands were born of the sea. Then it washed them in its translucent color and dressed them in its beauty. Join us on a magical journey to some of the most beautiful islands of Greece. Come and swim in the turquoise waters of Zakynthos. Discover the rugged beauty of Cephalonia, picturesque Ithaca, exquisite Lefkada, and cosmopolitan Corfu. Join us on a fascinating journey to the Emerald Islands of the Ionian Sea. Our first stop in the Ionian Sea is enchanting Zakynthos, an island with steep cliffs and extensive beaches with soft, fine sand. It is the island of the Caretta Caretta turtles. In Zakynthos, at Lagana Bay, at the Sekania, Daphne and Hierakas beaches, the Caretta Caretta turtles find shelter to hatch their eggs. One of the known and most photographed beaches of Zakynthos is the Navaio. Every summer, thousands of visitors enjoy the sparkling blue waters of this famous beach. Rather on the rocky western coast of Zakynthos, there are picturesque coves and many impressive caves, which are one of the main attractions for the island's visitors. The most famous of these is known as Galazia, the Blue Cave. Zakynthos is an island of luxuriant greenery. The verdant vegetation that covers it has earned it the name the Flower of the East. The Zakynthos earth gives its grapes a special aroma, making the local wine in much demand. In the island's picturesque villages, visitors can admire the distinctive colors of Ionian architecture. On boat trips around Zakynthos, which set out from the island's main town, visitors can reach the marvelous Keri Caves. One of Zakynthos's best-known tourist areas is the Lagana Beach. The island's beaches on the side facing Peloponnese are ideal for swimming, flat, sandy, and usually calm. The island's capital, also called Zakynthos, is a particularly beautiful town. Its main activities are concentrated along the waterfront, and it offers a variety of entertainment to suit all tastes. Continuing our magical journey to the Ionian Islands, we arrive at Cephalonia. An island of contrasts, where steep, rocky shores, exquisite beaches and rugged beauty, offset by a tranquil harmony of colors and enhanced by the fragrance of the Cephalonia fir tree, create a unique setting. Join us as we explore beautiful Cephalonia. Located at the northernmost tip of the island is one of the most picturesque communities of Greece, the enchanting Fiskado. A traditional village, it represents the old Cephalonia and is a popular tourist attraction with yachts and sailboats moored in its small port. The unique beauty of the island's beaches, especially the white sandy bay of Myrtos, leaves a lasting impression on visitors. One of Cephalonia's prettiest villages is Assos. Built in an idyllic, lush green setting, it is ideal for relaxing holidays. Cephalonia is the largest Ionian island and is ideal for excursions and exploring. Visitors can discover numerous interesting sites. The Drogorati is one of the most stunning caves on the island, with multicolored decor. It has wonderful acoustics and is ideal for concerts. Near the village of Nea Vlahata is the remarkable lake cavern of Melissani, referred to in Homer's Odyssey. According to the time of day, the Melissani cavern changes colors, a marvelous sight.
Continuing our journey in Cephalonia, we come across the sandy beach of Scala in a magical setting. Small coves still exist for those looking for unspoiled beaches. Lixouri is the island's second largest town. A pretty town, it features new buildings, streets and squares. Located near Lixouri are the beautiful beaches of Lepida and Xi. Argostoli, the island's capital since 1757, is situated next to the small peninsula of Fanari. It is one of Greece's most elegant provincial towns. Argostoli offers pleasant, relaxing vacations. When you go on your journey to Ithaca, wish that the way may be long, full of adventures, full of knowledge. Ithaca, known throughout the world as the island of Odysseus, Homer's famous hero. Bathy is the island's capital. Its houses create a particularly pretty picture, retaining the traditional style of Ionian architecture. During our exploration of the island, we discover lush green shores with translucent waters and wonderful beaches like Vexa, Mnemata and Skinos. Ithaca's sea breezes and its ideal weather conditions make sailing a favorite and memorable pastime. Frikas, a small seaside cove located on the eastern side of northern Ithaca. With its well-organized tourist infrastructure, it welcomes hundreds of visitors and boats during the summer. Kioni is the island's prettiest seaside village, boasting a number of old traditional homes. It has been classified as a historic settlement. Nestled in a small bay, Kioni has developed into a popular tourist resort. With its combination of mountain and sea, Ithaca is an island of great natural beauty and impressive sights. Ithaca, or Thiaki, the island of Odysseus, has become a symbol. A symbol of adventure. In the past few years, a variety of alternative forms of tourism have developed, like trekking, off the beaten track. Visitors can enjoy discovering the island's many attractions. Ithaca, the island of Odysseus, the perfect place for quiet but unforgettable holidays. In the middle of the Ionian Sea is the charming island of Lefkada. An island with pretty beaches, it combines mountain and sea. Its endless sandy beaches and its sparkling blue crystal clear waters create an exquisite setting. Luxuriant green slopes reaching the sea, one more beautiful than the other. Egremni, Porto Katsiki, Kathisma, Aios Nikitas. Nidri, the most touristic part of the island, is a modern resort built along the shore on a fertile green plain. Excursions by boat set out from here to the islets scattered opposite Nidri. Skorpios, the famous island of Aristotle Onassis, Skorpidi, Sparti and Maduri, the retreat of the poet Valoritis. Also located near Nidri is Megonissi, with its renowned caves, the Papanikolis Cave, the hiding place of the submarine Papanikolis in the last war, and the Demonos Cave. Those looking for something different, a marvelous waterfall is located near Nidri. The interior of the island conceals many surprises, like these traditional villages with their stone-built houses. Lefkada, a picturesque Ionian town which still retains much of its traditional elements. An intellectual and cultural center with a rich history and many sites of interest. Lefkada has a well-organized tourist infrastructure, maintaining the tradition of Greek hospitality.
Wow, oh, I feel good! I knew that I would not. I feel good! I knew that I would not.
The Ionian Sea is full of surprises. It is difficult to resist the charms of these two beautiful islands, Paxi and Andipaxi. They are definitely worth visiting.
I feel nice, like sugar and spice. So nice, since I got you.
Corfu, one of Europe's favorite resorts. The elegant old town of Corfu is sure to leave a memorable impression on anyone who visits it. The town is very lively. The main square, the commercial center, the esplanade or spianada, and the liston. The citadel is the fortified hill on the easternmost point of the peninsula on which the town of Corfu is built. Hundreds of thousands of tourists from all over the world come to this magnificent island, not only to enjoy the sea and the sun, but also for its active lifestyle. Corfu has one of the most efficiently run marinas in Greece. It is located at Gouvia, which has developed into a popular tourist center. To meet the needs of tourism, Corfu has developed one of the most comprehensive tourist infrastructures in the Mediterranean. Hotels offer a range of categories, from deluxe to the simplest accommodation, but always have a hundred. The Bay of Paleokastritsa, Corfu's prettiest place with its sandy beaches and olive groves. Others prefer water sports at Corfu's many beaches, as they enjoy the sea and the hot sun. But there are also parts of Corfu that have remained untouched by time and tourism, mountain villages drenched in greenery. The houses are distinctive with their traditional Corfu architecture. Corfu is full of beautiful beaches, busy or secluded, along all of its shores. Sidari, a prominent resort with lovely sandy beaches and all kinds of tourist facilities. One of its attractions is a natural passage formed by the sandbanks in the sea, which is called the Canal d'Amour, the Channel of Love. It is also worth seeking out the beaches still untouched by tourism, like the famous lagoon of Corisias, full of sand dunes with cedar trees. Corfu, the beautiful legendary island of the Phaeacians, is crowned by a superb jewel. It is the Achillion, built in the 19th century by the Austrian Empress Elizabeth. Pondicionici, the small piece of earth which has definitely become Corfu's best-known symbol. At sunset, visitors to the island, together with the fun-loving Corfuites, create their own magical atmosphere in the town and at the other resorts. The local nightlife generates excitement and fun for those who can take the fast pace. The Ionian Islands.